So we're going to consider a plain composite wall composed of three materials with different thermal conductivities. We're given the thicknesses of the three sections as well as contact resistances that exist at the interface between A and B as well as the interface between B and C. The left face of the wall is insulated. The right side is exposed to convective conditions such that we're given our H and our T infinity, which is 20 degrees C. Thermal energy is generated within material A at a rate of 5,000 watts per meter cubed. So we are asked to determine the maximum temperature within this composite wall. So let's take a look here at our picture. That gives us all the information. There we go. And if you recall, the equation for one-dimensional steady-state temperature is given to us by this equation. And so if we solve for T, we find that T of X equals minus Q dot K over X squared plus C1X plus C2. Again, this temperature distribution is always for this type of situation. The only reason it would change is because C1 and C2 will change depending on the boundary conditions. So the first thing we do as we look at the boundary between the heat generation, which is occurring in A, and the beginning of our conductive part of the heat transfer, which starts at B. So we can find the flux at that point has to equal the heat generation times the length of that wall. And so that equals 5,000 watts per meter cubed times 20 millimeters, which is LA, which equals 100 watts per meter squared. Now we can start our thermal circuit where our flux, 100 watts per meter squared, stays constant. Remember that you cannot include generation within our circuit. So let's start with TA, which occurs at X equals LA. And the first resistance it encounters is our thermal or contact resistance. Then we have our next temperature that we can call TA2. And this is the temperature that also occurs at X equals LA because of the contact resistance between the interface between A and B. Now we have conduction through B, so our resistance is LB over KB. And now we have our next temperature, which is at X equals LA plus LB. Again, we have another contact resistance between B and C, and we have our temperature after that contact resistance, which is also at X equals LA plus LB. Now we have conduction again through wall C. So that's LC over KC. And when we're finished going through C, we're at the surface. So that's our surface temperature. And finally, we have our conductive resistance and our final temperature, T infinity. So if you can recall from a thermal circuit, this Q double prime stays constant throughout. So you can find any temperature as long as you add up the resistances between the two temperatures. So that's what we're going to do here. First we'll find our total, and that involves adding the RTC, the LB over KB, the next RTC, the LC over KC, and 1 over H. So if you put those all together, you come out with 0.26 meters squared K per watt. So our Q double prime is TA minus T infinity over our total. And what we're really looking for is TA. We have Q double prime, we have our T infinity, which is 20 degrees, and we have our R total. So that allows us to find TA, which equals 46 degrees C. So why are we interested in TA? Well, we need to find the temperature at T0, and we're going to need TA, as you'll see, to be able to solve it. By the way, we could have solved for any temperature along this thermal circuit. So let's take a look at what we do. So we're looking for T at x equals 0. So we go back to our temperature distribution, which is minus Q 2K times x squared plus C1x plus C2. So we know the temperature at x equals LA. So T at LA, which equals 46 degrees C, equals minus Q 2K times L squared plus C1 times L plus C2. So that's our first boundary condition. That's a constant surface temperature of 46 degrees C. Now let's look at T equals 0, where we know, because it's insulated, that dT dx also equals 0, which equals minus Q 2K x plus C1. Since x equals 0, C1 has to equal 0. Therefore, our T at 0 is going to equal minus Q over 2K x squared plus C1x plus C2. Since x equals 0, our T at 0 is just going to equal C2. So how do we find C2? We go back up to here, remembering that that's 0, and we find that C2 equals Q dot over 2KA times LA squared, because remember we looked at this temperature at LA, plus TA, which equals T at 0. Therefore, T of 0 equals 46 degrees C plus our 5,000 watts per meter cubed times 0.02 meters squared divided by 2 times 0.24 watts per meter K, and that equals 50.2 degrees see.